one of the things that separates the Komatsu I machine or the Intelligent Machine Control 2.0 apart from any other aftermarket or any other factory included system has to do with these shortcuts that are right here on the screen. We only have two modes. We've really simplified it. We've made it work for the operator. The first and foremost, most important one is right here in the top. This is our simple grading mode button. So simple grading mode on and simple grading mode off. What does that mean? So anytime that an operator is working within simple grading mode and they turn on the automatic control, that blade's gonna go down along the surface as we see below the blade right here. It's gonna disregard any track slippage. It's gonna disregard any operator input, any mapping, any tilt steering. It's basically gonna function like a traditional GPS system. Its only goal is to put the blade onto the cut. Whenever we turn off simple grade is when things really start to change. So Intelligent Machine Control 2.0, what is it that makes it unique? You can take this machine, drive it over any given terrain, and it does not matter what the surface design is from the engineer that's underneath the machine. It's going to map the terrain as it sits right at this very minute. And then whenever we back up to take a cut is where the second icon comes into play. So we've got light, medium, and heavy cuts. This really doesn't have anything to do with material density as much as it does depth of cut. We even have the option to custom program how deep we want the machine to take a cut for every pass. Basically, it's going to utilize that map terrain that the machine drove over whenever simple grade was turned off. We can select how deep we want to cut, and we can take that material away in layers as it sits today. So very, very common issue is that we can grab an operator, we can throw them on a GPS machine, but it really doesn't matter until they get down to the design, right? So this gives that operator the ability to take layers of material away from the ground as it sits. So if that's grubbing for topsoil or stripping off in layers, trying to get down to a clay base, or just simply just trying to operate efficiently. Again, we've got light, medium, and heavy for different depths, so we can even program in our own custom cutting depth. You can kind of see an example of what we're talking about right here. Every time the operator backs up to take another pass, it's going to add that next depth to that next cut. When we're in these modes, we still have all the same advantages of track slip protection to make sure that the machine never overloads itself. We also have the ability to where the operator can, you know, he can manipulate that. So if the terrain's got like a side roll to it, while he's got simple grade mode turned off and he's taking a pass, he can actually change the blade angle left or right to manipulate how much cross slope we've got. Another interesting feature on the Komatsu I machine is the smooth start option. It was actually there in the first generation of machines, but it was never front and center right here on the screen like we see today. Basically, what smooth start allows us to do is if we're working in some really loose material like sand, it will actually slow the attack angle of that blade coming into that material, so that way we don't get that initial gouge or that initial blade drop that causes some type of surface disruption. If we're getting ready to throw down some concrete or some kind of paving aggregate, it doesn't do us any good to have an initial gouge whenever we start. Another unique feature of the Komatsu I machine is going to be the tilt steering control. Very, very commonly, most operators, whenever they've got a heavy cut, they've got a lot of material to get through before they get down to their final grade, they're actually going to manipulate most of the steering of the machine by changing the cross angle of the blade. The machine here with the Intelligent Machine Control 2.0, it actually looks at our cutting depth and it sees that we've got enough room to maintain a heading. As long as the operator is not physically steering the machine with the blade control lever, it'll go ahead and it will, as long as this tilt steering option is turned on and we're in a cutting mode, it'll actually tilt the blade to make sure that the machine travels in the direction that it was headed initially. This really, really saves on undercarriage wear, saves on hydraulic heat, saves on final drive component breakage issues. Again, another added feature is the lift layer control option. So we talked about the cutting modes. We talked about how it can map terrain and how we can take away that terrain in layers. We can do the exact same thing in a lifting scenario. Most commonly in the past, operators would take these machines and they would design a flat pad surface and they would put lifts in 10-inch increments or more or less, depending upon their aggregates or their type of material. This machine actually has the ability to do this in a three-dimensional manner. If we're working on a swale, or we're working in some kind of three-dimensional situation where we want to make sure that we have consistent lifts that go upward based upon a design, we can still use this exact same custom heavy light medium feature to stay with our design, stay with our map terrain, and we can build material up in a three-dimensional manner. So very, very different set of options on the Intelligent Machine Control 2.0 that we did not have on the 1.0. We also have our one-touch surface creation. So in the past, an operator had to go through a lot of different steps to create a surface. Today, we've got that right on the home screen. We can actually just build them right on the fly with one button. So they don't have to change a lot. They don't have to stop for a long period of time. We can do slope surfaces, flat surfaces. We can even throw crossfall grades on them and do compounded surfaces right from the home screen of the console. The idea is if we've got some kind of opportunity to simplify the operator's life and simplify their amount of user interface, that, you know, we can provide that to them. It makes their life easier, more efficient.